Hey everyone, welcome to the product overview video on the brand new eFlight Turbo Timber Evolution. Yeah, that's right, it is a new timber model, but it's not really an addition to the timber lineup. It is a replacement for the current Turbo Timber, which leaves the Horizon Hobby eFlight lineup with four timbers, which is exactly what they have today. But the new Turbo Timber Evolution takes everything from the original timber, the Turbo Timber, the voice of the customer of listening to exactly what timber owners had to say about what they liked, they didn't like about the original and the Turbo Timber, and it wrapped all those improvements of everything they've learned into this brand new Turbo Timber Evolution. I consider this like the new model year timber model. So yeah, while this release is a timber, it is like the new next generation timber. And I tell you what, they have made improvements from nose to tail, wingtip to wingtip on this thing. Everything has been really looked at and optimized and improved. And I tell you what, in my opinion, I have the original timber, and looking at this Turbo Timber Evolution, it is clear that this really is the best timber to date. So in this product overview video, we're going to start at basically the nose, work our way around the aircraft, and just kind of cover a lot of the really great things that Horizon Hobby has done to take the legendary timber model, which for a lot of us is our very first really stall model. It was for me. And taking that airplane and really just kind of brought it up to make it even more durable, to make it smarter, even make it even more capable. So let's go ahead and let's get started here right on the nose, shall we? All right, first you have the Turbo Timber nose. The shape of the nose is what you'd expect from a turbine powered aircraft. The original timber had more of a conventional kind of a flat engine, you know, typical gas powered engine nose on it. It was much shorter, a little bit wider, and with a two blade prop. And as you can see with the Turbo Timber Evolution, you have that longer nose that's more tapered, it's more slender, with the large turbine exhaust ports on the side, which really give it a pretty awesome look. I mean, if you've seen the like the Draco, for instance, you've probably seen some videos on that thing. You probably know something about that airplane. It looks cool with those great big exhaust stacks coming out. And just like the Turbo Timber, the Turbo Timber Evolution carries on that with these beautiful exhaust stacks coming out. We've got a three-bladed prop up front, very pointy spinner, which is common for a turbine-powered aircraft. And you got the two LED landing lights up in the nose as well. So from that standpoint, not a lot has really changed. The power system, of course, is still capable of 3S and 4S as well. And it does have a 60 amp smart Avian ESC installed on it. Now, the next feature I'm going to get to here as we kind of work our way back is one of my all-time favorite things that they have done to this aircraft. If you have the original timber and you have the Turbo Timber, you know that it's kind of annoying that the battery hatch is on the very bottom. So you got to flip the airplane over, pop off the hatch, put your battery in, put the hatch back on, flip it back over again for everything to start initializing. Well, they have taken care of that. That's no more. So you're wondering, well, where's the battery hatch? Where did they put it? It's not on the bottom. Where is it? Well, so yeah, that's right. So the battery hatch is actually mounted on the top now, and this anti-glare panel, the top of the cowling here, and the windscreen come off. It's a magnetic catch, and it's got this really great plastic surround molding both on the battery hatch and on the fuselage. So no more dings in your plastic or dings in the foam from taking this on and off. It's all the contact surfaces is now plastic. I thought that's a very, very awesome thing to do. And that exposes the gigantic battery compartment here. It will hold everything from a 2200 3S all the way up to a 5000 series 4S battery will fit inside this battery tray. I mean, this is a massive battery. If you have this thing installed, you could probably fly around for all day. You may have to like pack a lunch just to eat it while you're in the air. This thing will stay in there for so long. So incredible amount of versatility in what the Turbo Timber Evolution will hold in terms of battery. So if you do have the 5000 series though, just be known that it comes with an IC5 connector, and this is the IC3 connector in the aircraft. They do make an adapter. It's a smart adapter cable that includes the center post here, and it will adapt the IC5 to the IC3. Now that's really only for the 5000 series. If you're down in the 4000 series and 2200 series, obviously it's gonna bolt or plug directly in. The other thing to note is when you have the battery hatch off, you can see these composite carbon fiber rods that run back and forth inside the nose here. They go from basically the motor mount all the way back into the fuselage here, and it really strengthens this area up. It makes it a lot more durable. So basically the load from the wings, the load from the landing gear, and the thrust from the motor, all of that is really contained inside this kind of a carbon fiber box that's created by these carbon fiber tubes that run throughout the fuselage. Down inside there, you can also see the 60 amp smart ESC is installed in this as well. So, and that's what gives you that 3S, 4S capability along with the powerful brushless motor as well. Moving back through the fuselage a little bit more, it also has the AR637TA Smart receiver installed in it. This is a fantastic receiver. I have it on a few of my airplanes as well, both the T and the TA. So it has telemetry. So if you have a, basically a computerized radio, such as, the DX6 series, NX, 6-8, and IX series radios, you have the ability to gather the telemetry from the receiver, the battery, the ESC, the motor, everything is communicating to you. So that brings you a lot of really cool functionality. And I believe I even read that you have data logging capability with it as well. You can actually log your flights and review that data afterwards. I've never done that. That's something new for me, but I just learned that the other day that there's a lot of capability with this smart technology that, the more you get into it, the more and more you really learn you can do with it. But to start with, at least, you have the ability to get some very important parameters from the aircraft down to your transmitter on the ground. So really cool feature that Spectrum's come out with, and really just kind of setting that bar really high in terms of what these aircraft can do. These smart airplanes really, really are incredible. So what I mentioned before, this is the smartest and most durable timber to date. That smart technology is what makes it so smart. So you got smart battery, you got a smart receiver, you have a smart ESC, and that all communicates to your computerized Spectrum transmitter to really give you some really vital information. In terms of durability, got some more things to talk about on the durability scale, and it's still all focused right up here in the nose of the aircraft, right? The landing gear has been strengthened, and really it's the portion where it attaches to the fuselage. I know there are some reports out there of people damaging that area or seeing some stress cracking in that area. They've gone through and completely reinforced the landing gear mounting on the fuselage. It's completely redone. It looks bulletproof. I never had any issues with my original timber. I've had some not so great landings on that thing. But the nice shock absorbing landing gear that you get that really allow the aircraft to settle down in those big Tundra, oversized Tundra tires, really soak up bumps on gravel, pavement, grass, sand, you name it. It's a great landing gear system that works very well in the timber, but the mounting area in the fuselage seemed to be a little bit of a weak spot. Well, they've completely taken care of that. So. The other thing to note is that this really is a fantastic second airplane. So if you move from a trainer to a second airplane and maybe your landings aren't necessarily absolutely perfectly smooth, with this new Turbo Timber Evolution, the upgraded landing gear system where, the mounting structure is so much stronger, it's going to make your landings a little bit better in the sense of if you do get one wrong, you don't have to get the glue out later on that day to go ahead and fix it. Also in terms of durability, they've also strengthened and stiffened the wing section here. This is going to allow for a lot less flexibility in the wing, which then gives you a lot better control on the ailerons as well. So the plane will actually feel a little bit more responsive. I never felt that the original one had any real flex to it, but I can definitely tell you that the wing spar and the wing structure itself is stiffer. You can definitely tell the difference when you handle both of them side by side. Just as if As with the original Timber and the Turbo Timber and the Turbo Timber Evolution, you do get the lights installed. So you got navigation lights, landing lights, and strobe lights on the end of the wing. You also have these fuselage-mounted red rotating beacons on here, which I always thought this thing looks so cool in the evening when you are flying it. Really not much else has really changed on the back half of the aircraft. Still a very similar timber shape back here, the horizontal stabilator, the vertical stab, and the large rudder. Everything back here is pretty much what you would expect if you're familiar with the timber. Nothing dramatically new there. But you will notice, of course, this is a very unique new paint scheme. It's the bright red and black scheme on this aircraft. It really stands out. I love the anti-glare panel in front of the windshield here. I thought that's a very cool thing to have on the aircraft. And it, you know, seeing it here in the house, in the studio, doesn't give it justice. This thing really looks incredible when you get it in its natural setting. I had it out on the beach, I had it out in the yard, took it outside, and when you see the bright sunshine on it, the paint scheme really starts to look good. It's very, very impressive when you get it outside the house and into its natural environment. So a few more things I wanted to touch on, and that's in terms of something new that's going to be coming out. And as I mentioned before, this is a great second airplane, right? So let's say you bought the Habu or the Apprentice or any of the Horizon larger park size trainer aircraft, and it came with this DXS radio, right? So you bought the ready to fly model, it came with the DXS transmitter, and you're ready to move up, right? You've mastered the Habu, you've mastered the Apprentice, you're ready for your next aircraft, right? Well, the Turbo Timber Evolution here is a fantastic second aircraft, but you want to take advantage of the flaps. Timbers have always had flaps, even the UMX Timber has flaps, right? Well, traditionally, with the DXS radio, if you want safe to work and you want flaps and you have all your flight controls, you don't have enough channels anymore to operate everything. Well, there is a new firmware update that will be coming soon to the DXS radio. And at some point, all new models of the DXS radio will allow you to have flaps and safe. Yeah, that's right. You basically get an extra channel out of this guy. So you don't have to go out and buy a brand new expensive radio to fly this aircraft. Your DXS will work. You could take advantage of flaps and safe. However, there's some caveats to that. Since this is not a programmable computerized radio, you are stuck with the flap settings that it comes with, okay? So your takeoff flaps and your landing flaps are set. You can't adjust it. You can't say, I want to adjust my flap travel to less or more or anything. You are stuck to exactly what it comes with. That's not a bad thing. However, you also can't mix the elevator and flap together. So in other words, if you currently put the, you got a programmable radio, you program it so that when the flaps come down, you get some movement of the elevator to prevent kind of this ballooning or pitching up of the aircraft, right? Well, you don't have the ability to do that. However, if you fly with safe, you can change the mode of safe that you're in when you get ready to change to give it something on the flap input. If you want to take off flaps or full flaps, you can use one of the other modes. You can maybe use intermediate mode or beginner mode. And what that will do, you couple that with flipping of the flap switch, that will help prevent some of that ballooning. You'll keep the aircraft more stable. But with proper airspeed management, you could probably get away with it even without safe. But just to let you know that there is some limitations that come in when you have a non-computerized radio in flaps. But you will have the ability after a firmware update to do that, where you can still have safe and you can still have your flaps and as well as the rest of your controls. So that's a very exciting thing. And that's really one of the things that makes this new Turbo Timber Evolution coupled with a DXS radio just a fantastic way to graduate from a trainer into a more advanced aircraft. And one of the other things that I really love about the entire Timber lineup, the original Timber, the Turbo Timber, and the new Timber Turbo Evolution here, is that it comes with floats. And I love the floats that it comes with the spring-loaded rudder on the back that I talked about in the unboxing video. They're great. I think that those floats are absolutely fantastic. And that comes with the aircraft. So you get a lot of value with this new Turbo Timber Evolution, just as you did with the original Timber and just as you did with the Turbo Timber. And as I mentioned before, this new model does replace the Turbo Timber. That model will be discontinued. This is the new version that's going to be coming out. And I think they did a fantastic job of really taking a lot of the elements of the original Timber, the Turbo Timber, listening to what the customers have to say and incorporating that into this aircraft. They've made it more durable, they've made it smarter, and they've made it even more convenient. And of course, still, my favorite feature of it has got to be this battery hatch that comes off on the top. No more flipping the aircraft upside down, back and forth. Something else that I thought is also very convenient, I drive a small car, I got a Ford Fiesta, so not a lot of room to put an airplane of this size in, so I have to remove the wings to do so, but the wings now come with a pin connector that goes into the fuselage rather than all the individual leads, because you got lights, you got ailerons, and you got flaps, and so now you have just a set of pin connectors that go into the aircraft and plug in. That will make things very convenient for those of us who have to take the wings off. It's also worth noting that unlike the original Timber, this does include all Metal Gear servos. Mine came without those, and I've added those for more durability, but you get those with the Turbo Timber Evolution as well. So a lot of really great features, a lot of really cool stuff that they've done, and this truly is the smartest, most capable, and durable Timber yet. Color me very impressed. So it's time for me to get the aircraft ready to go. I gotta get the battery in it, get it bound, check the center of gravity, and get this thing to the flying field. But I gotta say, Horizon really did their homework on this. So the engineers at Horizon and eFlight have really pulled off something really spectacular here. And the aircraft, it looks cool. I'm sure it's gonna fly absolutely awesome. It does have the optional slats that I do not have installed. You can go ahead and put those on if you want. I have one with the slats already, so I left it off this one. But you get these cool little stickers if you want to put over the where those slats go. Personal preference if you want to install them or not. But I tell you what, they've given you all these great options. You can put it on floats, you can put it on landing gear, you can add the slats, leave off the slats, you can fly on 3S, you can fly on 4S. On 4S, this thing will get off the ground in like 2 feet. You can fly it from dirt, you can fly it from gravel, you can fly it from all sorts of things, you name it. This is just an incredibly capable aircraft, which is probably why it's one of the best-selling RC aircraft on the market. And I think with these new improvements, it will continue to be one of the best-selling and most versatile, capable, and durable RC aircraft on the market. If you guys got any questions at all on the new Turbo Timber Evolution, by all means, leave them in your comments below. Be more than happy to help you out. But I'm going to go cut this video now so I can go get this thing ready to fly and get it in the air.